हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी, वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स, व्हाट आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रीज, हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट ट्री, हाउ टू ट्रैवर्स अ ट्री, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आई एम गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर वीडियो सीरीज। इन दिस करंट वीडियो सेशन I am explaining you the concept of binary tree and its properties. Now let's move forward for the concept. Before moving to the concept, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. Now let's see what is binary tree. So binary tree or any of the tree, it is a non-linear data structure. Because it doesn't grow in a linear way, it grows in level wise. So that's why this is nothing but a non-linear data structure. If you want to know more about the data structure and its types, I am flashing the shortcut link in this right-up corner, where I have already explained the types of data structures with their examples. The binary tree is a specialized version of a general tree. What is the speciality that the binary tree is having? So the speciality is that in every binary tree, every node can have minimum 0 or 1 or the maximum number of 2 children. The maximum children count is fixed, is nothing but 2. That's why the name is given binary tree. Binary means 2. So minimum it may have 0 or 1 or the maximum 2 children that every node can have. And that's why this is called as the binary tree. If the maximum number of children are fixed, they are 2. So typically we can name both of them as a left child or the right child. With these names, we are going to call them as the child nodes of any of the node. Here, I am going to explain you it with the help of example. So, this is my binary tree where this is the root node. A is a root node. B is the left child of root node A. C is a right child of root node A. Here you can see that every node is having maximum 2 number of children. So it means that the binary tree property is followed by this particular tree. That's why this tree is called as binary tree. If you want to know about the different terminologies of tree data structures, they are root node, parent node, child node, leaf node, or different properties. For that, you can go through my previous video, is nothing but the terminologies of tree data structures. For your reference, I am providing you a shortcut link in this right-up corner. Now, let's move forward for the representation of binary tree. How to represent the binary tree? Very first thing, you must know the root of the binary tree. The root is the first element of your tree. So whenever you want to represent a tree, you have to maintain a pointer to the topmost node or the first node of your tree is called as root. So your pointer will be holding the value of your root node. If your tree is empty, it means that the root is null. There is nothing in the root. You can say like this, if your tree is empty, means your root is null, or vice versa, root is null, it means that your tree is empty. You can say in either of the way. Here, I am explaining you what are different parts of the binary tree nodes. So, the binary tree node is divided into these three parts. They are, first one is the data part or the information part. Then the every node is having the left child or the right child or both of them or none of them. So that's why the every node will be holding the information part or the data part. Here I am representing you it with the help of diagram. So here information or the data part you can store over here. If you can see the last example where the information is nothing but A, which was there in the root node. So here that information part or the data part will hold that information. Then the address of the left child is hold into this left child pointer, and this right child pointer will hold the address of the right child. So in this way you can represent the binary tree node. Now if we want to implement the same thing with the help of language or with the help of programming language, here I am explaining you it with the help of C programming language. So what the code I need to write down for the creation of the node or for the representation of node, not creation but the representation of the node. So whenever you want to write down the code or implement the code for tree data structure, we will be having that all the three parts in the node. They are the data part is the first part. You can see over here the data part or the information part. That may be of type integer, that may be of type character, or that may be of the type different entity that we'll see afterwards how it can be implemented. But right now you just keep in mind that data part will be there as the first or the important part of your tree node, and remaining two are the references to its left and right child nodes. They will be holding the references or the addresses. They will be of type pointers because they will be holding the addresses. So here in this way we can represent the structure node. So in this structure node, these are the three fields or three parts of your node. The here I am considering that my data part is of type integer, and my left child and right child are of type pointers, and they will be holding the address of the node. That's why the data type of these left and right child are structure node. This structure node, because the left child will be of the same data type structure node, as well as the right child will be also of the same data type structure node. I hope you are able to understand that how to represent the node structure with the help of programming language. Now let's move forward for the binary tree properties. Which are the properties basically the binary tree is holding? The first property I have already explained you, that the binary tree is having either 0, 1 or maximum 2 number of child nodes. Now let's move forward for the next properties. So the property 1 is with respect to the height of the tree. So you must know first of all what is the height of the tree. So the maximum number of nodes in whole binary tree with respect to the height h, if we are knowing the height h, then the maximum number of nodes, maximum, not the fixed count, the maximum number of nodes the binary tree can hold are nothing but 2 raised to h. H is nothing but the height of your tree minus 1. This will be the count, which is saying that this is nothing but the maximum number of nodes are present in that particular binary tree. The property number 2 is with respect to level. Here I am explaining you that the maximum number of nodes which are present in the level, particular level L. So level wise how many number of nodes can be present in the binary tree is explained by the property number 2. So that is nothing but 2 raised to L minus 1. Here you are going to see that this is 2 raised to H will get calculated first, and then that value will be subtracted by 1. Here we are subtracting the L minus 1, and then we are calculating 2 raised to L minus 1. The difference between both I am going to explain you it with the help of example. So now let's forward for the property number 1, where we are calculating how many maximum number of nodes can be present in the tree if the tree is having height h. So let's see this example where the tree is with the height is given, and here I am calculating the maximum number of nodes can be present in my tree. Now let's consider only for the height 1. If the tree with the height 1 is there, then the property says 2 raised to h minus 1, that is 2 raised to 1 is 2 minus 1 is 1. So maximum number of nodes present in the tree with height 1 is 1. Next, if I am going to consider only this much tree, and here the height of tree is 2. So what my property says, 2 raised to h minus 1 is 2 raised to 2 minus 1. 2 raised to 2 is 4 minus 1 is nothing but 3. So the maximum number of nodes are present in whole tree are 3. Next, can be 3. We can't say that every time this will happen, because the maximum number of child nodes are 2. That's why here we are able to calculate the maximum number of child nodes are available. This is not applicable for a general tree, because for a general tree it is not at all fixed how many maximum number of child nodes are present for every parent node. Here it is fixed, that's why we can find out, but this will be the maximum number, not exactly the count. This count will be okay if your tree is complete binary tree. Now what is complete binary tree, that I am going to explain you in the next video lecture. So right now you just keep in mind that the maximum number of nodes can present in your tree are 2 raised to h minus 1 if the height of your tree is h. Now let's move forward, let's consider the whole binary tree, whatever I have given the example over here. So here in this whole binary tree, the height is 3, so the 2 raised to 3 minus 1, 2 raised to h minus 1, h is 3, that's why 2 raised to 3 minus 1, 2 raised to 3 is 8, minus 1 is 7. So here you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, total number of maximum nodes can be present in this binary tree are 7. So in this way you can find out the maximum number of nodes in binary tree if you are knowing the height of the tree. Now let's move forward for the property number 2, where according to level number we are finding the maximum number of nodes present at that particular level L with the help of formula 2 raised to L minus 1. Here L minus 1 we will calculate first, and then we will find out the power of 2 raised to L minus 1. Let's see the same example. Here I have mentioned the level as well, and let's start for the calculation. If my tree is having, or if I want to calculate the number of maximum nodes available at the level 1, is nothing but 2 raised to level is 1, that is L minus 1 is 1 minus 1 is 0, so 2 raised to 0 it should be 1. Now after that we need to move forward, that is for the level 2, that is 2 raised to 2 minus 1, that 2 minus 1 is 1, 2 raised to 1 is 2, and for the level 3, 2 raised to 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 raised to 2 is 4, so that's why the maximum number of nodes are available at the level 3 are 4. So here we are finding the number of maximum nodes are present at particular level with the help of this property 2. So in this way, if we are knowing the height of the tree, we can find out the maximum number of nodes can be present in the tree if it is a binary tree. And if we are knowing the level numbers, then we can find out the maximum number of nodes present at particular level, and we can find out the count in the binary tree. So thank you dear friends, I hope you are understanding the concept of binary tree with its properties. Please do not forget to give the comment and like my video. Here I am providing you the subscription link for my channel Tech Talks along with the next video of this video series as well as the whole video series with the help of playlist. Thank you.